Well, this is it. Today is undoubtedly the biggest day on the NRL calendar.
So this morning we've brought in the big guns. NRL great Darren Lockyer, Broncos legend Sam Thaiday, Nine commentator extraordinaire Ruan Sims to give you the ultimate guide to the blockbuster at a Core Stadium. Yeah. First to you, Lockie, it all comes down to this. You've played in four premierships with the Bronx. What do you reckon? It's just such an amazing day.
It is a big day, and I think for the Broncos, it feels good. Like they've been the last 2 months, they've been playing some really good football. Yes, the Panthers are looking to make their own history with a three-peat, and they're a great team. But I feel like there's a bit of momentum with the Broncos, and there's a lot of Brisbane people are down here for the game, and there's a lot of excitement in Brisbane.
A lot of Brisbane down here, but we are very close to Penrith. What do you think the atmosphere is going to be like inside that stadium tonight?
Well, I think you only got to look at yesterday when Collingwood are up against the Lions. Anyone that doesn't go for Penrith in Sydney that doesn't want the Panthers to win, I guess a lot of them will be behind Brisbane. So I think the atmosphere will be great tonight. I think it'll be electric.
Yeah. Sammy, to you, what would be going through the minds of the players as they're waking up this morning?
A few of them are actually a bit tired. There was a bit of a rave going on the other side of the stadium last
there?
Night. I wasn't there, but I think there was DJ Jerome Luai was there, and he had the doof doof going to midnight. But there would be a little bit of nerves there. It is a big day, but there is a few players within this Broncos team now that have played in big games, played in State of Origins, also represented their country. So that'll take a little bit of the edge off, but they just can't be overawed by the occasion. I think they can withstand the Panthers for this first 20 minutes of this grand final. It's going to be a cracker.
Speaking of the big players, let's talk about Reece Walsh. How much will the Broncos be relying on him, and how much will Penrith be targeting him?
Yeah, massively. I did go and get my Reece Walsh eyebrows done just for the game, actually, for the grand
final. Looking good.
I wanted to look as good as Reece Walsh. I'm still not quite there yet because he's a handsome man. But, I'm sure you'll see Cleary at some stage put some towering bombs up towards him. He'll be testing him out as much as possible, but in their defence as well. We saw what they did against the Warriors and trying to shut the Warriors down and some of the players out the back there. So they'll be trying to do the same thing to Reece Walsh, stop him from doing what he does best.
Before we get to Rue, just quickly, as former Brisbane players, what would it be like in Brisbane if they could do it, their first since 2006?
Well, 2006, we went into that game as underdogs, and we're underdogs tonight. But I think considering where the club was 3 years ago, Wooden Spoon, to where it is now, I think that's an enormous achievement, which a lot of credit needs to go to Kevin and his coaching staff and Dave Donoghue, and his staff and the football department. But I just think Brisbane have got behind them in the last couple of months, because they beat the Roosters at the Gabba, and that's when I knew they were capable of winning this. And I think Brisbane have gone on that journey with them, and it's a huge night for not just the club but the city.
Ruan, I mean, we're a bit stacked on this desk with Broncos legends here, but a three-peat for Penrith would be pretty amazing.
It would be incredible. They are building a dynasty, and they've been just top of the pops for a very long time. They do the small things really well. They transition beautifully. They're very physical. They're very fit. And they love that challenge. But I'm actually with the Broncos legends today. I've actually tipped the Broncos to come away with the win.
That's all right. Yeah. Lucky and I.
It was the eyebrows that did it for me. I was like, those eyebrows, I'm going
it's
to the
working,
Bronx.
So
going to the Bronx. No, so, and I think it would be an incredible achievement for the Panthers to be able to go three in a row. They've been to four grand finals in a row. So regardless of the result, this team that they're building and the dynasty they're building is absolutely incredible out at Penrith. And they've got a lot of the supporters behind them. They've got the players base to do it. But I'm tipping the underdog today.
Specky day for women's sport as well. NRLW grand final. Of course, we're going to see the Knights and the Titans in action. How do you see that one playing out?
Well, this one is a really tough one because my heart is with the Titans here. They've been an incredible story. Karen Murphy's done a brilliant job with this entire squad. Last year, they finished Wooden Spoon. This year they're in the grand final, their maiden grand final appearance, and they're on the cusp of being the first professional team to bring a championship back to the Gold Coast. And their defence last week to hold the best team in the women's competition to 0 points in the Roosters last week, 12-0 win, that was fantastic. And they're going to need to do the same thing today if they want to try and get over the Knights, because the Knights have the best defence in the competition, but attack is their main thing, and I think defence is the Titans' biggest thing. They're both those biggest threats. So if the Titans are able to supersize the effort that they did last week against the Roosters and they can bring the Knights into a dogfight, they're really in this. I am, however, tipping the Knights. And one reason I'm tipping them as well is I just ran into Ronnie Griffiths on the way over here. He said he had a great night's sleep last night. So the rave didn't affect him yesterday.
Maybe he was at the rave.
He might have been there. Yeah. But he was very cool, calm, collected, and obviously the skill set of Tamika Upton, the Dally M medalist.
That's where you've got to stop.
Yeah, you've got to stop both of their fullbacks. Yeah. Politi for the Titans and Upton for the Knights. They're their two biggest attacking weapons. And also defensively, they both organise the defensive line so beautifully. The communication is fantastic. So I'm really excited to see the packs go head to head. You know, we always talk about, games are won by the forwards, the backs decide by how much. And I think this one in particular today is going to be an absolute pearler.
Sam, we'll see you on the DJ decks later.
Yeah, 100%.
Great.
Yeah. I was going to say, the women have to be tougher because they've got to play in the heat. It'll cool down a bit by the time the blokes get out there. Yeah. So.
All right, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Star-studded panel there, and you can stream exclusive live and free NRLW content on 9 Now. Just a matter of hours now, the Panthers and the Broncos will battle it out for the premiership right here at Accor Stadium. So many of the champions are here and have been instrumental in the push to the finals. Mm. One of them is Steve Renouf, who joins us. He currently holds the title for scoring the most tries for the club. He joins us right now. Good morning.
Morning. Thanks for having me.
How are you feeling?
Mate, a little bit nervous. Quietly confident. But, come kick-off time, I should be okay.
Yeah.
Now, we've got this little guest in here with us, and you're part of the team that lifted this trophy for the first time. Does it bring back memories?
Yeah, 1998, and, got to lift that one. So that was awesome, and as you know, it's pretty heavy. So
yeah.
It's like...
I tried to lift it before, and I couldn't do it. Now, Reece Walsh, how much of a gun is he, and can the Panthers stop him?
Well, look, they're going to have to because Reece, he'll just unleash when he needs to, and I think Kevy gives him that free rein. So, he's always a handful, but, Panthers are pretty tight with their defence, so it's going to be pretty tough.
How has the coach been able to turn things around so quickly? I mean, it has been a bit of a slow build, but this season it's just been sensational.
Yeah, I think he's got that team believing in themselves, and they bought into the belief of what the club is about. And I think Kevy brought that back to the club. I think we lost that there for a couple of years. Mm. And so with this playing group, a lot of those boys were there a few years ago as well. So they're like 3 or 4 years older.
I think we've got some vision now of the Broncos on their team walk this morning. They look pretty relaxed, it must be said. And the underdog tag gets thrown around a lot. I mean, are you happy to wear the underdog tag?
Yeah, we're always underdogs, so that's okay. Queensland are already underdogs, so we'll wear that well. Obviously, Penrith deserve to be favourites, So they're trying to go do the three-peat. And we're trying to stop it.
I mean, their team is so strong. This is their fourth grand final. They've already got two trophies in the bag. I mean, how nervous would that be making the Broncos players?
Well, I think they've probably got the less pressure on them, to be honest. I think we've got nothing to lose. Penrith are going for their three-peat. I think they'll probably have a bit more pressure than what Brisbane does. And we're down here and just absorb it.
Bit of Queensland weather for you too. It's going to be really hot.
Oh, I know. It's pretty warm. I'm glad I'm not going out there, I can tell you.
Well, what's it like as a player sort of walking into that cauldron? Is it something that takes your breath away?
Yeah, it does, mate. It really does. And you go to a packed stadium. I mean, I was fortunate enough to play in 4 grand finals. And, to have that, you just can't repeat it, to be honest. So that's what the boys have just got to have to soak up the pressure. But they've got to put that in their favour and go out there and just enjoy it.
How much would they have been focusing on their defence this week? Like, you talk about Panthers having good defence, but you've also got to stop them scoring tries. Like, what's the most important thing for the Broncos team?
I think defence. You're right. That they work on that. They work hard on that because we know we can attack. We've got some great outside backs. But it's all about being tight in defence, and I think that's what'll win them the match.
Steve, do you like getting lippy around the place? Like, you see some Penrith fans here. They've had enough success, haven't they?
Yeah, they've had enough. Look,
do you still throw it out there, like with the jibes around the place, like you did on the field?
Oh yeah, no, I'm pretty quiet. I just sort of say,
you're too nice. Okay, we've got to get a tip. You got a tip?
No, listen, I'm confident that Brisbane will get home, and hopefully by 10 points. So
10 points.
10 points.
One point to do it.
Yes, just one point to do it.
That's all you need.
Field goal.
Hey, thanks so much. Good luck.
No worries. Yeah, thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Thank you.